This is gonna be a masterpiece? Wonder Egg Priority's a new anime on Funimation, and it's already like the best show. What, you think I'm joking? You think I'd sit here and promote something for free if it wasn't the best goddamn piece of media out there? I don't even talk to my own family for less than 30 bucks, and like nobody's talking about it. I was talking about the first episode the first week it came out so much that nobody could stand being near me. I was the worst. I was just ranting about this Japanese Coraline girl like left, right, and center. I wanna wish myself and my worst enemy. And really, isn't that the best compliment you could give a show? That it makes you a fundamentally worse person? Alright, so at this point, I should probably tell you what it's about. In the most vague terms possible, it's about a 14-year-old girl who finds an egg, and a mysterious voice tells her that if she cracks it open, she'll get the one thing she wants most. Half the show takes place in the real world, and the other half takes place in her dreams. And though the show may look and sound cute, it is dark as hell. You wanna cry episode 1 of an anime? Boom, this is your show. That's pretty much all I can say about the plot without spoiling anything. Although I will tell you, if you like the Persona games, you'll probably love this. This is like very similar to Persona, actually. Okay, so what can I tell you about the show? First off, do I even have to talk about the animation? Oh my god, just look at it. Anyone with two balls in their skull could tell you this animation's gorgeous. It's insane that we're living in a time where a TV show could have this much detail in its animation. Oh, but Danny, I hear you cry. Good-looking anime's a dime a dozen. Yeah, so what do you want? You want quiet, contemplative moments seamlessly integrated with exciting, bombastic action scenes? Boom, we got you covered. You want complex and believable characters? What, do I look like a fucking hack to you? Who is it you think you're talking to right now? I always deliver. The main character, whose name I'm not even gonna try and pronounce, is like one of the most compelling characters I've ever seen. She starts off like cold and standoffish, but it's like clearly a defense mechanism. Which, I know, sounds like every anime edgelord out there.
Everyone I know ends up dying. I'm too dangerous to love.
She's not that melodramatic, don't worry. Instead, she actually feels like a real teenage girl. You can tell she wants to have friends and gossip and have fun, but the years of trauma and bullying have conditioned her to reject getting too close to anyone. And it's heartbreaking because you could tell there are moments where she's really trying to make friends, but something inside of her is just like pushing her back. Yeah, let me just tell you, this is a sad one. This is an absolute heart crippler of an anime. I watched the first 3 episodes like 3 times each, and every time I get chills without fail. I mean, we're talking all the triggers. Depression, suicide, self-harm, assault, you name it. I mean, these are incredibly intense and sensitive subjects, especially when, you know, anime's not known for its subtlety. I'm looking at you with Silent Voice, you fucking melodramatic train wreck.
Should I say that? People are gonna be mad.
Wonder Egg Priority, which I'm fully aware is a ridiculous name, handles these themes maybe better than any show or movie I've ever seen. And that's because these themes are handled with such subtlety. Ai doesn't get angry and violent when she's upset. She gets closed off and quiet. She freezes up and disassociates. I think anyone who's struggled with anxiety or knows someone who has can really relate to how it's handled here. It's just unyieldingly sad. And on top of that, so much of the story is told visually. The show knows that sometimes being quiet and thoughtful is way more effective than being loud and dramatic. And yeah, I know, ironic coming from me.
How long?
Look, we'll get a second opinion. Chris, how long do I have?
I don't know!
When those moments hit you, it feels like your heart's gonna explode into a fucking pink mist. I mean, they could've released the first episode alone as its own standalone short film, and it would've been one of the best shorts I've ever seen in my life. I mean, there'd be like a weird cliffhanger at the end, but you know, that's how shows work. But there's so much packed in this first episode. So much emotion and so much to analyze that it feels like its own complete experience. And I don't mean that in an obnoxious way. You're not gonna need like a 3000 IQ and a window into the writer's psyche just to understand what's going on here. You see, the egg is a subtle shade of off-white. Not too perfectly white, but not too opposed either. Obviously, a very clever homage to Sergei Eisenstein's theory of montage. Yeah, none of that shit. You're not gonna be sitting there at the end of an episode like,
what the fuck was any of that?
I mean, like the fun kind of analysis. Kind of makes you want to stay up all night, digging through rabbit holes and typing on message boards, looking through people's theories. Except in this case, you can't because nobody's talking about this goddamn show. It's very psychological and has a lot of metaphorical elements, but all the pieces are there. Like, I can't remember the last time I had this much fun theorizing about a show, or the last time I've been so insufferable to be around. Really, the only issue I have with the show so far is that I'm constantly terrified it's gonna do something to make me hate it. There's a certain direction I'm hoping it goes in, and a certain direction that I'm desperately hoping it doesn't. And now you're probably saying,
oh, well, Danny, why don't you just wait till the show is done to make a review then?
Awfully chatty today, aren't we? Well, for 2 reasons. One, like I said, nobody's talking about this. I mean, yeah, it's getting some attention, but not nearly the attention it deserves. So hopefully this video will help. And second, even if the show utterly disappoints me by the end of the season or series or whatever they're doing, first episode will still remain one of the best pilots I've ever seen to a series. So if you take anything away from this video, for the love of God, go watch that first episode. Did any of you enjoy this? Let me know in the comments if you like this video, if I should do more like this. Oh, and also my captor has told me that if I get more than 10,000 views on this video, he'll let me out of this fucking basement. So fingers crossed. So if you like this video, give it a like, give it a share, help me.